In July of 2017, the Montreal Organ Festival proved to be a spectacular, fun-filled, information-packed event held in Montreal, Canada. Myself and hundreds of organists from North America all converged on the city July 2nd to July 6th for a fun-filled week of organs, friends, architecture, and good times. Myself and Rob Corso, organist at the Cathedral Basilica of Christ the King in Hamilton, were so taken by some of these churches, we knew we had to get back there to check some of them out. In October of 2022, when much of the world had reopened, Rob and myself were able to get back to Montreal to check out some of these interesting organs and churches that we'd first seen in 2017. After a lot of prep work, a lot of planning, it was time to go. Way too expensive to fly. Monday morning, October 17th, we set off for Montreal via rail, business class. It was time to get to work.
There he is, the happy traveler. How's it going, Rob?
Fantastic.
Good train ride?
Had a great train ride.
Nice little stop in Belleville.
Yep.
Excellent.
Enjoyed it. How are you doing?
Very good. I hear it's hailing back home.
Is it?
Yeah, Danielle said it's hailing. So, all right, I guess we're off to the hotel.
All hail to the king.
A couple of cameras, a couple of sound recorders, a MacBook, it was time to set out.
Rob, you ready to get on the subway?
I'm ready.
Heading to St. John Baptiste. It's about 9:30 in the morning.
Looking forward to it.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
It's exciting to be on the Montreal Metro.
We don't know if we're on the right one, but we're going to find out. It's a nice system here.
Very clean.
Our first stop was St. John Baptiste, located just a little above the downtown. Opus 615 from 1915, an organ of 80 ranks, 56 stops, 4 manuals. Fantastic organ in a fantastic building. With very limited time in all of these churches that we were at, there was no concert material, just a few hymns, just a few sound samples, but just basically seeing what these instruments could do when we had our chance to be with them alone. Thank you. The immense size of the church alone, seating over 2,800 people, with a balcony that fully encompassed the front part of the church through the transept. With that, we headed back to the hotel for some lunch and to get some plans together for the evening. We decided to head across the road from our hotel to the Cathedral Basilica of Marie Reine du Monde, Mary Queen of the World, which was actually literally just across the street from our hotel. A vast church, 1/7 the size of St. Peter's in Rome, and resembling it in a lot of ways. The church is just absolutely stunning, with amazing baldacchino, crypts for bishops and cardinals. We were able to speak with the administrative staff there just right before the Mass, and they were all fantastic and very friendly. However, all of our correspondence to the organist to come and try the organ was not returned. Following that, we headed down to Old Montreal, to where Notre Dame Basilica is located, and to see, funny enough, that the exact same construction on the towers was the same as what's happening at the Basilica in Guelph. A lovely downtown fall evening. We were able to just sit and enjoy the bells and take in the scenes. Very friendly, very active atmosphere in Old Montreal. We did send several correspondences to Notre Dame, but alas, again, our correspondence remained unreturned. Wednesday early, we set out to trace Saint Nom de Jésus, which is in the East End, Montreal. We took the subway, we were able to see the Olympic O, the big stadium.
Rob, who got off three stops too early. That's okay.
After a subway ride and a bus ride, we arrived at this enormous edifice of a building. And once again, a wonderful interior to match not only the outside, but also the instrument that was held inside. This organ, Opus 600, also from 1915, the same year as the St. John Baptiste organ, was slightly bigger and had some very prominent divisions. The bass was earth-shaking, and the front echo organ at the front of the church was bigger than most regular organs in any other church. Once again, our time was limited. We set up some cameras, some recorders, and set about to just going through the vast tonal resources of the organ. once again, we had the friendliest staff and also the assistance of Alex Strauss-Fausto to put us in connection with all our Montreal contacts to ensure this visit even would be successful.
Thank you.
This is a bombard, you think? I
don't know. This got to be like high pressure facade, like right here. Blew it right apart.
No, that's damage. That's damage. I know. Of something. Workmen or whatever.
Well, that seems fine.
This must be the. No, it's not the receipt, but this bombard was here, I think.
Yeah, the bombard's on the side. What a fantastic instrument.
Yeah.
After riding high on these experiences, it was time to head back to the hotel and get ready for supper. We downloaded the footage, dumped all the files, and set out to grab a bite to eat before it was time to prepare to head home the next day. We had tried to make one more stop on our trip available, St. Joseph's Oratory, but again, like Notre Dame and the Cathedral Basilica downtown, our correspondence remained unreturned.